In this video, we will learn about list in Dart. In any programming language, the most common data structure is arrays that are the ordered collection of objects. In Dart, arrays are list, and defining a list is very easy in Dart. So the syntax is we write list, that is the class name, and then our list name. For example, let's say I want to store some names. So whenever you want to store multiple variables or multiple values, you can use a list. Now to define a list, we use this list literal, that is a pair of square braces. Now inside this, we can put all the elements or all the values that we want for our list. In this case, let's put some names. So we have a list of names that contains three values. In Dart also, the list index starts from 0. So if you want to access the first element, what you can do is you can write print and then names, and then inside square braces, you will put the index of the item that you want to access. For example, I want to access the first element, then I will write 0 here, like this. If I run the code, I will get John. So the basic principle of list is very similar to other languages. Now, if you want to add more elements to the list, you can easily do it. You can write names.add and you can pass whatever value you want to add. Let's say I want to add a new name. So I can add it like this. Now, if I print the whole list, for example, I want to print everything that is inside this list, then I can just pass names. And if I run the code now, I get all the items. And you can see the new item is added in the list. You can also remove an existing item. For example, I want to remove names.remove. And to remove an item, you can either pass the object or you can pass the index and it will remove that index. For example, I want to remove the first element and I also want to remove Peter. So I will remove Peter like this. Now, if I run the code, you can see we only have two elements now because two elements we removed from the list. So in Dart, a list is dynamic and you can add or remove items from the list. If you want to create a constant list, then what you can do is you can put const keyword just before the list literal like this. Now, if I try to add or remove items from the list, I will get an error. Let's run the code. And you can see we are getting exception. And the message is cannot add to an unmodifiable list. So this is how you can create a constant list. And in a constant list, you cannot add or remove items. Now, there is one more way to define list because in Dart, you do not need to define types explicitly. And that is why instead of this list, you can simply use the var keyword and it will work. You can see we are getting the exception because the list is constant. But if I remove the const keyword, then what happens is the code compiles successfully and we are getting the two items because we had four items after adding this item. And then we removed two items. One more interesting thing with list in Dart is you can put comma at the end of the last element as well. And you will not get a compilation error for this. And this feature can prevent the copy paste error. For example, if I want to copy the last element, what I do? I just press Ctrl D or Command D because I'm using a Mac. So we have a comma at the end, and that is why to prevent the copy paste error, it supports a trailing comma at the end of last element. So if I run the code now, it will work as well. As you can see, we are getting all the values. Now, if you want to traverse all the elements of a list, you can use a for loop that we learned in the last video. But in Dart, we can simply use for loop like this. I will show you. We can write for and then name a temporary variable where you will store each element of the list, and then in keyword, this is a keyword, and then finally the name of your list like this. And you also need to define the data type. For example, the list is of type string. So here I can write string, or I can simply write var as well. Now I can print the name, and it will print all the names one by one from the list. You can see we are getting all the values. Now, if you want to create a list from an existing list, for example, I will use the same list and I will delete these repeated values from this list. And now I have a list names. Now, if I want to create one more list, for example, I have var names one, and I want to create a new list and I want to add all the elements of this names list inside this list, then it is very easy using the spread operator in Dart. So what I can do is I can put my new elements. For example, I want one more name in this list. I will put my name, and then I can insert all the items from this names list. And to do this, what I can do is I can write triple dot and then names like this. Now we will create a new list that will contain this new element and all the elements from this list. So if I loop through this names one, then I will get all the new values. You can see we are getting the values from the new list that we created. You can also use the null safe operator with this spread operator to have null safety. For example, assume this names might be null. So you can put this operator, and if the names is null, then in that case, it will ignore inserting null value to your list and you won't get any error or exception. So this was the spread operator. Another interesting thing with list and Dart is you can use if else or loop with the elements only. For example, we have some condition. If that is true, then only we will add this Tony inside our list. So here I can write if, let's say some condition, if this condition is true, then add this value. This will also work. So here you need to write a proper condition. For example, I will create a Boolean variable. Let's say add equals to false. Now here I will check if add is true, then add this Tony. So let's run the code. I will comment this line for now and I will print the names list. Now if I run the code, I will get only two names because this condition here is false, and that is why this name will not be added to our names list. So let's run the code and you can see we are getting just John and Peter. So you can use if else inside your list, and you can also use loops inside your list. For example, I want to add this 5 times. Then what I can do is I can create a loop here. For example, for where I equals to 1, I is less than 6, I plus plus, and I will add values like this. Now it will add this value 5 times because our loop is running 5 times. Now if I print all the elements from the list, then I will get, you can see I'm getting Tony 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is how you can use control flows to control how you add items inside your list. So that is all for list, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something. Thanks for watching.